Hello friends, here in OCM subject, in video session or in the last online class, we have started the chapter number 4, okay? Chapter number 4, it is the communication, e-commerce and outsourcing. So, up to this, in this chapter, first of all, we have completed what is communication, process of communication, and then internet, what is internet? Land, man, van. Okay, so these all are we have completed. So after land, man, van, can, LAN, land. Okay, so these we have all we have completed up to in the our video class. Okay, so in here after communication there are the next point of our chapter. It is the e-commerce. Okay, so now here we have started on the e-commerce. E-commerce means it stands for the electronic. Okay, it means electronic commerce. Okay, electronic commerce. Commerce means the trade plus trade related activities. Okay, we have shown in the earlier chapter. Okay, so means electronic commerce. It is here the all the transaction of the commerce, all the transaction of the business or all the trading of the or the business have done by the electronic commerce or the electronic gadget. It is done by the electronic gadgets. Okay, electronic gadgets and through the electronic medium. So now in the e-commerce, in our business, there are the purchase of the product, selling of the product, advertisement of the product, compensation given to the product to the seller. Okay, etc. These all things are done with the help of the e-commerce, means with the help of electronic medium or electronic gadgets. Okay, so nowadays we have seen the using the e-commerce or using the internet. Okay, using the internet nowadays in our mobile there are different application of the e-commerce. Okay, like the Amazon, Flipkart. Okay, at any with the use of this kind of application, at any time at any place we have purchased or selling any product with the use of internet, with the use of e-commerce. So with the use of the e-commerce, there are the business have run smoothly and it is also beneficial to the customer or customer also. Okay, because now there are some of the product we have shown that the price is the very cheaper than the local market price of any product. We have seen directly we can search in our application or in the Google, then the price of the product is very cheaper as compared to the local market price. Okay, so there are the benefit of the customer also. Okay, so here there are the in e-commerce means the electronic gadgets means product purchase, selling, product and product compensation, product advertisement, all these things doing with the help of the e-commerce, means doing with the help of the electronic gadgets and electronic medium. Okay, so nowadays we can see that at any place or anywhere we can buy anything from our using our internet, using our mobile phone, using the application. Okay, it is the very beneficial for the e-commerce. So nowadays there are the important one in the business. Okay, e-commerce. So on the basis of the parties which are included in the e-commerce, parties included in the e-commerce, there are four parts divided here. Okay, so in the first one it is the B2C, B means business. Okay, B means business. Okay, another it is business to customer. Okay, first one it is the business to customer. So here in B2C transaction, the customer directly place the order through the online application or through the use of the internet, and directly the businessman or the company man can send the product whatever the address it is given at the time of the order. So here it is the directly connection between the business, means between the company and to the customer. So here it is business to customer, it is the first point. So in that there is the, like example we can give, it is the online order. Okay, we can buy anything from the online. Okay, so when we buy the online product at any product, we buy the online product. There are the no middlemen are there. Directly we contact with the company and directly the company can send the product with us. Okay, so here first it is the B2C, business to customer. So now first it is B2C, second it is the B2B. Second point is the B2B. B2B means the B stand for business, business to business. Okay. First it is business to customer, so then second one is the business to business. Means here both the parties are included, the professional, both the parties are the businessmen. Okay, so here there are the one businessman, okay, one businessman that sell their product to the another businessman. Okay, for example, like the in any company there are using of the raw material. Okay, there are needy or necessity of the for making or producing the any product, there are raw material are there. Okay, so for the raw material, the company, okay, the for the raw material purchasing of a raw material, the company they buy the raw material to the another company. Okay, so here there are both the companies are the businessmen. So here it is B2B, means business to business. Okay, in this there are the mainly management of the supply, management of the product, management of the employees are included on our days also. So here there are the management things we can done here. So now here supplier, middleman, producer, supplier, middleman, agent, these all are included in the business to business transaction. So second point, it is the B2B, business to business. So first it is B2C, second it is B2B, and now third one here it is the C2C. C2C means customer to customer. Okay, here there are C2C means customers to customer. Okay, so here there are two customers, means two sellers. Okay, one is sellers and one is buyer. So they both are directly connected with the each other using the internet. Okay, here trading activity are with the help of internet, the both the person are connected with each other and there is no middleman in the C2C, customer to customer transaction. Okay, means here mainly there are the second hand product are available. Okay, so one person means one buyer means one is seller and another is the buyer. Okay, means both are the customer. Okay, one is suppose I have buy a car. Okay, I have buy a car in the year 2016, but now in the year 2020 I want to sell the car. Okay, so here there are different websites, different level applications are there to directly, like I can show the buy. Okay, I can sell my car. Okay, like Quikr, OLX. Okay, these are the main example, main important example of the C2C customer. Okay, so as I put my details, my photograph of the cars, details of the car. Okay, so these all are in the whoever the customer wants to buy the car, they will show the details and contact me. Okay, so here there are the third one, it is the C2C, customer to customer transaction. Okay, so here fourth point, it is the customer to business. Okay, here now customer to business, fourth point. Okay, customer to business. So here first of all, in this type of commerce, customer gets the large facility, customer gets the large choices of the product. Okay, customer get the highly benefit in the price also. Okay, so there are the mainly things, it is the large choice of the product, large choice of the product. Whatever the, suppose there are one things I have product, buy a directly we can buy a, for example, mobile. So there are the thousand or different types of mobile, different types of companies mobile are there on the website. Okay, so using the internet, here the customer can also sell their product to the business. Okay, so means customer to business, there are the fourth point. Okay, so here there are the in the e-commerce, there are we can mainly parts of the fourth point. First of all, B2C, business to customer. second it is the B2B business to business, third it is C2C customer to customer, and fourth it is C2B means customer to business. Okay, so here there are the types of the e-commerce also included here. Okay, now there are also main types of the means B2B, B2C, C2C. Okay, C2B. Then another it is the sum of the more arrangement of also the e-commerce. Okay, it is also e-commerce. Nowadays there are including the government and individual body also. Okay, so here there are the in the government, like first of all it is the e-commerce or trading, online transaction or online trading, it is done by the government to customer. Okay, government to customer also one of there. Another it is the government to business. Okay, and another third one it is the government to government. Okay, government to government. Okay, here these are also three types of more transaction, more trading in e-commerce. It is that government to customer. Okay, means government to customer, government sell their product to directly to the customer using the e-commerce. It is government to customer using the internet. Another government to business, government and sell their product to the businessman. Okay, suppose for example, we can take for example from the farmer, the government have buy any product, for example wheat. Government have buy the wheat, and this wheat the government has sell out to the businessman. Okay, so it is government to business using the internet, using the e-commerce. Third one, it is government to government, means the one government have sell their product or any kind of transaction, online transaction, selling, buying, advertising, anything are doing with the another government. For example, Gujarat state doing the online transaction, doing the e-commerce to the, for example, Maharashtra state government. Okay, so here there are the in the more types of e-commerce, government to customer, government to business, and third one it is government to government. Okay, now next it is the equipment for implementation of e-commerce. Okay, for doing the e-commerce or implementation of the e-commerce, what are the equipments are the necessary? What are the equipments are needed? In that, the first one it is the website. First one it is the website. We all have very well known about the website. What is website? Means www.google.com. It is one of the website. www.saraswatischool.com. It is also one of the website. So www, for starting the e-commerce, for doing the e-commerce, for doing online business, first thing it is the website are important one. Without website, we cannot do online business. Okay, so first of all, website are there. Okay, so in the website, there are the implementation of the website, there are the different product we can put in the website. Okay, so in the website there are the many, it is a beneficial for the our business also, and for the online transaction it is much necessary for the website. So first one it is the website, and in the website for the upgradation of the our business, for upgradation of our services, which are the services we have provided. Okay, what are the benefit of our services, what are the product of our business provided, what are the benefit of our products, what are the prices, this etc, these all things are included in the website. Okay, it is started from the www means world wide web, www full form it is world wide web. Okay, and the website it is the not only used shown by the single person or the group of the person, it is shown by the any person in the world at the any place at the any time. So here it is, first of all the website is the important one. So here we can start in equipment, first it is website. Okay, now second one it is the computer with internet connectivity. Second point it is the computer with internet connectivity. So here after the completion of the website work, here we can purchase or we have to computer with the internet connectivity, because without the computer, without the internet connectivity, there is no such kind of website are open, or we can know
or the any other or how the customer can whatever the customer can visit our website, how we can know. Okay, so for the computer with internet connectivity are there. Okay, so for our upgradation of our business, okay, starting our business, upgradation of growth of our business, there is a computer with internet connectivity is must be there. Okay, so here in equipment, first website, second computer with internet connectivity, and third one it is credit card or debit card. Credit card or debit card. Okay, credit card or debit card means first of all, what are the difference between debit card and credit card? You all have known. Okay, we have earlier discussed about that. What are the difference between credit card and debit card? Okay, so here in the e-commerce or the online transaction, both the parties, buyers and seller, both are not known to each other. Okay, both are the stranger. Okay, so for the trust making with trust for the each other, the person cannot pay it directly to the customer. Okay, or nowadays there are maybe we have shown that there are many fraud or banking fraud are there. Okay, so for the security purpose, the nowadays suppose there are the credit plastic money means credit card and debit card are included. Okay, so for buying of goods or selling the goods, there are mainly we make them first of all we make the secure and then give the debit card or credit card number to the person. Okay, but we can make the directly to the seller at the time of the payment or the at the time of the payment. First of all, is the cash on delivery. If cash on delivery option are not there, then credit card and debit card are most important one. So using the credit card or debit card number, we buy any product at the secure website also. Okay, so here for the equipment for implementation of the e-commerce, first of all, website are there. Computer with internet connectivity must be there, and third of this credit card or debit card are there. Okay, because without credit card or debit card, we cannot buy a product. Okay, so it is important one. So here there are the e-commerce. Okay.